Hey guys, how you doing? Scott again here from Scott's Bass Lessons. Hope you're well. Today I want to talk about a concept or lesson that's pretty much the most important lesson that I teach to any of my students. And it's important not only to bass players, but musicians, guitarists, piano players, oud players, even artists. And if you're working towards anything creative, it's really important. If you look at me, I'm relatively successful, as far as I'm concerned anyway, or the way I measure things, measure success anyway, I'm pretty successful. I can kind of pick and choose which gigs I want to do. I don't have to do the graveyard shift gigs anymore. I can choose to do gigs that really inspire me and, you know, light my fire as a bass player. I've taught at multiple universities. I've been musical director for artists that have been signed to, like, big labels such as Sony and EMI. I'm founder of scottsbasslessons.com, which is a wicked free online resource for bass players of any level, beginner, intermediate and advanced, and that's kind of going from strength to strength at the minute, scottsbasslessons.com, so check it out if you haven't already. But you know, it didn't start off like this for me. I wasn't an overnight success. That's what you didn't see. A lot of my friends and musicians that I've met, it's kind of a habit that people talk about, the overnight successes, or the guys that were, you know, playing with Miles when they were sort of like 6 years old or something like that. And that wasn't one of me, you know. I wasn't born with any of this. I wasn't born into a musical family. My parents didn't cultivate me from a young age and played me amazing music like Weather Report and Shakti or anything like that. They listened to ABBA and Rod Stewart. Sorry, ABBA fans, but you know. My education was really crummy, and even when I tried to get into university, I was knocked back because I didn't have the qualifications that were needed. But so how from that? How did I get to where I am now from where I came from? And the answer is lots and lots of tiny baby steps. That's what you need to do. Break things down into tiny, small, bite-sized pieces and understand that they are the building blocks that give you the outcome that you're looking for. Look, Rome wasn't built in a day. And as true as that is, you're not going to become some super whiz-bang bass player overnight. That's just not going to happen. But look, some of the students that I've had have played in West End, they've played New York Broadway, they're playing around the world in big sign bands. And the one thing that they all had in common was the concept of taking small bite-sized portions of information and using them as the building blocks to create a bigger picture. It's like building a house. You can't do much with a brick, but you can do something with a few thousand bricks. In fact, you can build a mansion. Now, each tiny little bit of information that you learn is just like a brick. You might not see it to be relevant, you know, at all, but each brick links to each other brick and builds something of greatness, which is going to be your bass playing. Now, everybody, this, and I really want you to bear in mind as well that every great bass player could be Jaco Pastorius, John Patitucci, like these are jazz guys, could be like rock guys, Steve Harris from Iron Maiden, Flea from the Chili Peppers. All these guys started exactly the same. They didn't know what a scale was. They didn't know what an arpeggio was. They didn't know what a chord was. They didn't know any notes on the bass. They didn't know how to pluck with the right hand. They didn't know how to finger the notes. They just didn't know. They were exactly the same as any beginner. And it's really hard to, when you're watching these great guys on YouTube or DVDs or wherever you watch them, it's really hard to imagine that at one point they were exactly the same as you were maybe a couple of years ago, or maybe the same as you are right now. They didn't know diddly squat, okay? But what they did is they had a process of learning the information they needed to, whether they were thinking about it or not. They had a process of learning small bite-sized bits of information and then bulking that all together, maybe consciously or subconsciously, bulking it all together, and that's what makes them great musicians. When I first started playing, I pretty much quickly figured out that playing music, good music, has little to do with technique, okay? You're not going to get a gig if you're the fastest slap bass player in the world. You're not going to get a gig if you can tap multiple melodies or anything like that. You'll get a gig if you're a great musician and you understand music and how it's built, how chords are built, how harmony works, how melody works in relation with bass notes, all this kind of stuff. And because of that, I made it my mission to every day learn a tiny, it could be the tiniest little bit of information, but that could be the key to unlocking something else. And it's something I really, really strive to do. Every day before I went to bed, I made sure I just learned something, a tiny little bit of information, and it really made the difference to me and got me where I am today. And don't be embarrassed to ask. I tell my students this all the time. I suffered with this at school. I was always embarrassed to ask. If I didn't know something, I was the kid at the back of the class. I was really shy. I didn't want to put my hand up and ask anything like that. So I just sat at the back of the class and didn't. And therefore, you know, after 5 years of school, you know, I came up with pretty much no qualifications. So don't be afraid to ask. It can be the key to getting to where you want, and the actual sort of like block. If you're scared to ask, it'll be the block that stops you getting to where you want. For instance, if you were driving to my parents' house or something like that, you know, and I said they live in this country at this address on this street, but I'm not going to tell you the number of the house. I'm not going to tell you the number. Okay, that's tiny, small bit of information. It's the key to, or that's the key you need to know to be able to get to my parents' house. Otherwise, you'd be on the street and there's like 3,000 houses on there. Okay, so you'd be driving up and down the street for, you know, I don't know, months. Well, maybe weeks. But, you know, all you need is that tiny little bit of information. And that's exactly the same as music. You just get these tiny little bits of information, then you bulk them all together, and that's what's going to pull you through and get you to the next step. So you've got to have the big picture goals. I always aim high, and I tell everybody, every one of my students, aim high. Never aim low. It's going to do you no good at all. If you're aiming low, it's because of preconceived ideas. You want to be aiming as high as possible. But having that big picture, aiming for that big picture, you've got to understand that it's not all going to come at once. You've got to break that into small, small pieces. And by laying that foundation and building upon that foundation, these little baby steps, that's what's going to get you to achieving that big picture dream or goal that you want. Now, another thing that is really, really important is gratitude. You've got to be grateful for what you've got. And it's something I do all the time. Every time I lie in bed, I go to bed every night. I try to go to bed every night. When I get into bed every night, I try and think of three things that's happened that day, or in this case, that I've achieved that I'm really grateful for. Give yourself a pat on the back, okay? Don't beat yourself up. Achieving these tiny little baby steps is what's going to get you to where you want to be. So when you're lying in bed, if you've transcribed 5 seconds of something, if you've discovered some new bass player that's really inspiring you, if you had a jam with some friends and you felt like you played quite well, be grateful for it. Give yourself a pat on the back. It's something that people don't do enough. It's so easy to really sort of like get yourself bummed out on the negatives and think, oh, this isn't happening, that's happening, that isn't happening, and I'm not progressing as fast as I should be. Get rid of that. Be grateful for what you achieved today. Be grateful for what you'll achieve tomorrow. It's going to do you, it'll just, you know, it'll really, really benefit you in the long run. Now, and understand as well that, you know, taking all these baby steps, you're not always going to take the right step. And that's cool, because when you don't take the right step, you also learn something from it. You also learn something from it. If you've been practicing something for 2 weeks and it's just not working out, well, that's great, because you've learned that that's not going to work for you and you need to alter it a little bit. It's all about tailoring what you're learning for yourself. For instance, like a golfer, he, you know, there's no golfer that's sort of like, well, you know, some golfers, Tiger Woods, hits the golf ball, it goes straight to the tee. The average guy, he knocks the golf ball and, you know, it goes in the direction of the tee. You know, then he has to readjust. Then he has to hit it a little bit further towards the tee. Then he'll readjust again. This is exactly the same. It's about aiming for that goal, doing what you need to be able to sort of like get yourself on that way, and then readjusting and learning about readjusting along the way. You've got to learn to readjust and learn to help yourself become a better bass player. You don't have to rely on other people all the time. It's about being thoughtful about what you're learning and really investigating what you need to do to get to the goal that you're getting to. So what's this lesson actually about? What am I trying to tell you? Well, I'm trying to tell you that it's all about baby steps. Just learning small bits of information, but doing it over a really long, extended period of time. I'm also trying to tell you that it's about patience. And I'm sure you can imagine doing this, learning small bits of information every day over an extended period of time, it does take a long time, but it's the only way to do it. So it's about being patient with yourself, but also, you know, understanding that you do need to give yourself a kick up the arse sometimes and be truthful with yourself if you're not putting in the work. You know where I'm coming from, but be patient, and when you deserve it, give yourself a pat on the back and be, you know, every day try and reflect on what you've learned and feel good about what you've learned. Feel good about it. Don't let it just slide by. Look, and the most important thing I'm trying to get over is that your destiny and what you're trying to do in life, whatever it is, it's in your hands and only your hands. Nobody's going to sort of take you and, you know, give it to you free of charge. It comes with hard work, and that's the key. It comes with hard work and understanding that the power is in your own hands and no one else's. Look, I wasn't given the perfect start to become a professional musician or anything like that. I started really late. I think I started playing bass when I was 17 or 18. I didn't do particularly well at school. When I tried to get in university to study music, I was knocked back. But using these baby steps and learning small little bits of information every day consistently over a long period of time, I ended up teaching university. I ended up getting a first class honours degree. I ended up flying around the world, playing for loads of different people, having the best time of my life. And what I'm trying to say is that you can do this too. You can do this too, and don't let anybody tell you that you can't. It's in your hands. So if you put the work in and learn the correct information, small bits of it, every day, consistently, over a long period of time, you cannot fail. It all comes down to you, patience, hard work, and putting in the graft. Hopefully you've enjoyed this lesson. If you haven't checked out scottsbasslessons.com, please do. You know, about 100 free videos on there at the minute, and I'm adding every week more videos. And if you subscribe to Scott's Bass Lessons, I should say that you get free exclusive videos that aren't on the website and they're not on YouTube either. Some of my best stuff. So subscribe, you get sent that, and you get sent an EP, a single or something. Loads of free stuff anyway. So hopefully you've enjoyed this lesson. If you like the lesson, click the like button and take it easy, and I'll see you in the shed.
We'll be right back.